Thank you very much for the feedback. And you know, as you speak, and every time when I interact with entrepreneurs, I always come to the same conclusion that, you see, entrepreneurship is not easy. To run a business is not easy. And it shouldn't be easy. And if you decide to start a business, you must know that there are inherent and associated problems that comes with running a business. And one of those is that you must have finance, and you must employ people, and at the end of the month, those people must be paid. Whether end of the month or end of the week, they must be paid their salary. And they don't care whether you are a good boss or not. Whether you give them hugs every day when you come to work. At the end of the month, they change until they get their money. So you must know that those are problems that comes with being an entrepreneur. It's like someone who owns a house. You can't have a problem with water bill or electricity if you don't have a house. So if you have a house, you must expect that you must pay for electricity, you must pay for water, you must at some point maintain the house. So you can't complain that, no, I must pay for electricity, I must pay. People who don't want to pay for water and electricity, they don't want houses. They stay with their parents until they are very old. Some of them, because they just don't want those problems. Say, at the end of the month, I don't want to be paid. So I don't want to meet an entrepreneur who complains and say, you know, I had to use my money. This is your business. Whose money must you use? So that right there, there's a problem of mentality. To believe that, no, for me to have a business, government must give me money. It's a very, very, very sad. I think we need to have we must do a lot of work on the mentality of our people. Because everything is about government, give this, give that, and all that. And I don't have a problem with government having to help, because I also always tell our people, you know, if you look at the government budget, I think now it's sitting at 1.3 trillion rands. Government budget nationally, what's 1.3 trillion rands? I think with about 300 million being being borrowed. So we need 1.3 trillion, but we could not collect 1.3 trillion. And about 500 billion of that goes to salaries in government. And then there's few other billions that goes to education. Think about 150 billion, if I'm not mistaken, that goes to education, and then you've got another 100 billion that goes to social grants and all. So you can do your maths or start deducting. So it means, and then there's money for houses, then we must build roads, and we don't like e-tolls. So it means government shouldn't toll the roads anymore. It must find money from that 1.3 trillion rents and all that. So these are the problems we are faced with in government. So we will not complain that we've got this problem, because we are in government. We must find a way of balancing and resolving these issues. But the truth of the matter is that there will never be enough money from government to finance all of it. And this is why what I said to GP, I don't want the mandate that I've given to the acting CEO and the board. I don't want a GEP that will, it's not possible that it will fund everybody. But I don't want the GEP, there's somebody who was telling her story, 2 years trying to just get help. That can't be right. If we can't help you, why must we wait for 2 years to tell you just that we can't help you? For 2 years. Because we're raising your hopes, and you stop looking at other things and all that. So I want the GP that if we can't help you, we must tell you we can't help you. Because I know there are people who don't accept that answer. There's one Met guy, I think he's got the same surname as mine. No, I don't know if he's here, he's Met. Because he thought, no, because we've got the same surname, when he goes to GP, they must give him money. And I don't know how you got my email, because I don't even know you. So we are not related. So he was threatening everybody there at GEP, because he wants them to give him money. And I told him that for the same reason that we've got the same surname, they shouldn't be giving him money. And I think, because the next thing I'll be in papers claiming, being accused that my cousin, I don't even know this person. And if it goes to the papers and I say, I don't know this person, people say, oh, they've started politicians lying. They've got the same surname and all that. So I'd rather have people coming to me saying GP has not given us money, because they say they don't have it. Well, they don't have it. Where should they get it? They must get it from government. If government has allocated a certain amount, that's what they have. So that's why I want us to think differently and say, how do we? I mean, I like the idea. Where's the guy who was talking about? Yeah, you see, the problem is your preface. It's like, we're doing this thing because government is not helping, so we're doing it. The initiative is good. You should have long done it. Don't do it because government is not doing it. That's not the right attitude. But I like the idea of creating your own funds, creating our own funds and raising money. In fact, what we are doing now, I gave now the GEP new mandate. I said I'm going to raise 100 million because we don't have a lot of money. I'm going to raise 100 million, and that 100 million, I want to use it as a facilitation fund. So everybody here who says they want money, want to agree with the banks that no, we will take you to the banks, because our people don't want to go to the banks. They don't want to, you know, GP has been owed more than 100 million, I think now. You know why they don't want to go to the banks? Because the banks don't play. You don't pay them, they will repossess, they will take you to task. What will GEP? You will phone the MEC or phone the Premier, you will march, you will do all sorts of things and all that. So if we want to do a business right, we must fund, because we'll take you to some of the government funding agencies, national, like the IDC, they fund big projects, NEF, but they will never have enough money as well. So with this fund that I want to create, is to then facilitate, because when you go to the banks, most of you might not qualify, because the banks will say you don't have collateral, you don't have this and that. That's where GP will then come in. You want 20 million, they want 2 million, GP will come and say to the bank, there's the 2 million, borrow them the 20 million, so that you can be able to do business just like that. So the issue of funding would want us to deal with it differently. But at the center, it is the entrepreneurs who must be at the forefront of thinking about how to raise money. Because when you develop an idea of starting a business, you must also think about the sustainability of that business and whether it can go. So that you don't go to business for the sake of going to business. At least if I can have a company. Don't be like the people you meet who says, hey man, help us. And when you ask, what help do you need? He just says, no, just give us anything. Shut up, pretend that you're going outside to order. And you say you're in business, you can't. So you've got some of our people doing that. And sometimes it's because of unemployment and poverty. You can't blame people that much. But when you're in business, at least you are an entrepreneur, you must know that firstly, this is, you should have researched at least. And know with manufacturing, you'll never go wrong. You'll never go wrong with manufacturing. The most important thing is the market access. If you go to DRC, Angola, Botswana, any flight, any day, most people who are in those flights are South Africans. Because these countries are dependent on us for a whole range of products and goods. The only difference is that these South Africans are white and male in most cases. And we have opened these opportunities as this government. And that is because we want to, sometimes our people want to remain, do business. That's why you've got this thing of people saying, no, we don't want people outside our location to come and do business here and all that. You think if you're doing business in your own space, will you grow and succeed? No, it's not. Business doesn't work that way. So that's why I said there's a lot of things we must work on in terms of the mentality of our people. Because once, it doesn't matter how much money we can put and give people, but if the mentality is not right, we will not be able. And I was happy when the lady says she has been able to go to Gibbs. Well, I'll tell you, we won't pay for Gibbs. That I'll tell you, we won't do. But what, you see, what is important with what you have said for me? And because the reason we won't pay is because I know sometimes when you say no, when you are a tapunia, you must pay this. People say, but we don't have money. And I'll come to that issue. You know, to be an entrepreneur as well, you must be educated. And being educated, I don't necessarily mean going to school and getting a degree and all that. But you must be educated. Because you can't be in an industry that you don't understand. You can't go into an industry that you don't understand. So you must be educated about your own industry, first and foremost. And you must be educated about business. Because one of the reasons why our entrepreneurs don't succeed, some of them, not all, is because people don't take time to try and understand their industry, to try and understand what it means to run business. Because if you get retrenched today, you start a business and you think you are secured. And that's not the case. Because sometimes it takes long. And sometimes the problem is this hand to mouth. You see, I meet a lot of people. Yeah, you just gave me machines. Thank you very much. And I like what one lady said there. You gave me the machine. Thank you very much. But now I need a space to operate. No, I like what the lady says. I mean, there's a President Thabombeki was narrating a story about an imbizo he went to address. And there was this old man who stood up in the meeting and thanked the president. And thank you, Mr. President. The government has built me a house. But now the problem is that my windows are broken. So now the government must fix the windows. And it's the same. You can't say, the reason we gave you the machine is so that you make money. Don't take that money and buy food. Yes, you see, separate business from personal. You can't run it business. That's the other problem. Sometimes we run our businesses like there is no separation. How can I 200 rand that unga 50 rand or a share? Yes, it's important. Unfortunately, we are poor. But you see, we can't be in business to perpetuate that poverty. And I always tell people when you go that I don't want people to say hunger tona yabo road to fail or yamilimi. You shouldn't be in business if you are a child. You should be in business because you want to be a millionaire, you want to be a billionaire. And to become a millionaire and a billionaire, it's not easy, it's very tough. Ask any millionaire, they will tell you how they've been able to make it and how difficult it has been for them. And it means you must sacrifice a lot. You might have to sell your car, unfortunately. You might end up having to, when you make 1,000 rands, you just take a salary from that 1,000, which is 100 rands. You know, you can't just wake up and decide that today I'm going to Cape Town and you take from your business. You wake up and decide today I want to entertain my friends. I'm just throwing a party. You take from business. And when it's not working, you come back to government. No, but remember, you gave me a machine. But my first question is, how much are you making? How much money have you saved? Where now when you come back to us so that you can be able to take your business to the next level. And you can't tell me that you don't have the money when you are saying you are already in business. I want that lady, because I'm not talking to issue this, I'm not following my notes, but the lady, the same lady who's in manufacturing, I forgot the name, I have it here. When you were saying there's a company that wants to renovate, it's a good thing, we are interested, in fact, we will work with you. You will just have to give us your details so that we follow up when this meeting ends. We'll get GP to do that. I just hope, because you see, sometimes I know these things sounds good. You know, the big guys come, want to help. But when you find that when they get there, they just want us to give them a government property for free. We are not going to do that. We are not going to do that because we will definitely take you on your offer, help you. And I don't know if you've got people from DID here. I saw, is there? Yes. Lebogang Maile works for DID, Department of Infrastructure Development. I'm sure you know, Debza, that Premier has said in the properties that we own as government. Okay, firstly, those of you who are in property, there's opportunities. We're selling about 5,000 of our government houses. Some of them are in Rosebank, Santin. There will be an online auction. So start raising money, buy and go and sell. Those of you who are in property. Because we don't need government to be having houses. Some of them, we don't even know where they are. Some people are staying there, they are not paying. But there are instances where there's, for instance, schools which are not longer in use. And we said some of those schools, we can convert them to make them working spaces for our people. We've got some government-owned factories, especially owned by SIFA. Some of them have been hijacked. There are people who are there, they are not paying. So we are interested in helping with the issue of space because it's a big, big issue. And especially for a young woman who's in manufacturing, I'm particularly interested, acting CEO, to make sure, because she's manufacturing doors. And I'm happy that you are supplying a builder's warehouse. We build schools and hospitals, and we don't know where these doors are coming from. You must be one of the people who help us to supply the doors. Obviously, there are processes in government, so you must not say tomorrow I promised you that you are going to produce the doors. But you must be one of the people that, because every day we build schools and we build hospitals, we spend billions of money. That's where we want you guys to, because we want to know who's giving us this, bricks, who's giving us window frames and doors and all that. That's what we want to make sure that happens. So start looking at business from that perspective of manufacturing, because there are opportunities. Every year government spends money, but you know what happens? We come, we get the business, meaning we, yourselves, but because you don't have the capacity, you still go back to white owned businesses and you buy from them, they become your supplier. That is the problem. This is why we want you, if you are in the doors business, we want to look at the value chain. What are the components that goes into making a door? And where do you buy? Because if everything that you use to put the door together, you buy it from a white man, it's still the same. You're not helping us. You must then say, how do we develop somebody who will supply you with the other components and all that? I hear everybody saying, if you want money, it must be in 24 hours or a few hours. It's not going to be possible. And I'm not going to demand that from GEP because this is not our money. So you don't just sit and decide that, no, I like this order, so we'll give you money in 24 hours. It doesn't work. It's government money. The next thing we'll be accused of stealing that money. That is why there must be processes in government. So we are not going to give you money in 24 hours. Or 48, there must be a process. But I agree with you, it mustn't take 14 days. I agree with you, 14 days, it's a lot of time. Let's find a way of reducing the days. But it will not be 3 hours. On a Sunday, somebody sitting at the comfort of their house, you send them a message and say, I won't pay 100,000 anymore, as if it's your money. Check the government. It's not going to work like that. We must keep this money, your government. And the next thing, Taboria, about what challenge and all that. But how we want in 3 hours? And just ask yourself, if they can give you in 3 hours, it should be scary. You must just ask yourself, Uri, how else are they doing? So, in conclusion, there were issues around agriculture. I think we are interested. And I'm happy. So, Utenge maliyamu, tractor, business yako, kumele utenge maliyamu. We are not going to feel, we are not going to feel guilty for people using their own money. You are using, you must use your money, and I'm happy. But I want you as well to give Umam Dalila your details, because I'm interested, because uwe and Umama lana, usis lana, then bukuno mama futi. Not using our fair mama. But it's fine, give the details to Dalila. I'm interested. Who says who owner or me ola nara remorekezi mchini, remorekezi irrigation, mara are yakumula utasu huye, you interested. Yeah, now going interested. The lunige umam Dalila ma details, because uti asiz no sizos satumela bani sejabula mawufuna ukuthi size yabo uyabonisa ukuthi uzimisele, but we must also see ukuthi into esifana nama seeds ama fertilizers if siyakhona ukukusiza through agriculture siza kusiza lapho. So if uniku umam Dalila uzakhlanisa nabantu base agriculture, are the people from agriculture here? But you are from agriculture department, I mean the department. You are from the Department of Agriculture? Oh, okay. I wanted people from there. I don't know why they're not here. And you see, your story is encouraging. ALD is a government agency. It's our agency. So sometimes people say government and AIDC. Just say government, the AIDC. And we need to have more and more. Because sometimes when things go well, we don't say it's government. We want to say, somebody help me. He hasn't increased. When things don't go well, this government is not delivering. So it must be government throughout, during good and bad times. And everyone can partake in the township economy revitalization. Someone was asking a question here. Everyone can partake. And then you have, Machoba. Yes, ma'am. There are opportunities. In fact, if you give him talent, he will link you with people from agriculture. One of the departments I'm responsible, I'm actually responsible for two departments, is agriculture and environment in the province. There are a lot of those. But sometimes people want to have their own land. You won't get it. You know, we've got 2,000 people who benefited from government land program. And none of those farms are effectively utilized. And yet everybody says, I want to farm, give me land. So my first issue is, let's link you with some of these people and you can start farming already there and take it from there. Help you once GP to deal with those in the database only. We will try to help them, but it mustn't be bow. No, necessary again. If somebody comes with a brilliant idea and we are able to help, we can't say if you are not in the database. We shouldn't do that. Yeah, no, this is serious. Our Tusel Unafen. Then there's Godfrey. Where's Godfrey from the cooperatives? Yeah, is it Gordon? Yeah. No, we work with everybody. We want to work with everybody. The only problem is, and I was saying, somebody, when in most cases, meetings like this, when somebody says, no, I'm offering my services, we don't have a problem. Just don't come to me and say, it will cost you this much. Because that's what happens in most cases. People say, no, we are offering our service and all that. I want people who will say, we've got our own resources. And by resources, I don't mean money. It can be intellectual property, how these things are run, and all that. How can we partner with you to build the cooperatives? Because it is important that we must build cooperatives. It is important that we must build these cooperative banks. So we want to work with you. So I don't want you tomorrow to say, hey, remember you agreed. So here's a proposal, and the budget is 150 million. That's what we get. I don't want that. I want you to come work with us, and if there's money required, you must see how do we raise money with you and finance the project.
I have already dealt with the issue at Tamsanqa, and then if there's somebody, I'm told because I was out, there's umama, Oteng, Giteng Zamsiza, payments. Oh, umama. Yeah, you know what you must do, because I don't know. Was it, which department was it? Oh, JRA, and it's a subcontractor. See, that's the problem. But we will try and link up with the subcontractor and ask them what they, we don't have control over them. So I can't say batao bata, because we don't have control. The only thing is to ask JRA, which is Johannesburg Road Agency. And I think, Luena, just get her details. And let's just write to the MD of JRA and let her tell us what is that company. And that's the best we can do. But otherwise, I can't say to you, Kitawagrela Chele, there how. Kitawagu Utama. But I will do my level best to intervene, because that man is already sitting in somebody's pocket. And this is the problem, you see. This is the problem because. And there's a point that the lady raised about the kick, the startups. We need to think, how do we want to help startups? And when I started, I said in this meeting, it's people who have business. I didn't say we don't want to help others. We don't have a choice. We're a government of everybody. So we can't say we choose who to service. We service everybody. But in this meeting, and I did say I just wanted people who have businesses, who are running businesses. Because from this meeting, I can tell you there are a lot of issues like the one around the startups. How should government help them? And that's the type of feedback we needed. And in the last questions which were raised, because we also have people from other departments here. There's DID, there's housing, so I'm told they've organized lunch. So as you network there, the government people will still be there. So you can talk with them. The people who work for government, the officials, they're here. So you can. I won't be there. Yes, I won't be at lunch. I'm going to the next meeting. Yes. So, Mam Sonto. Upu Mam Sonto. Oh, yeah. Saying Kulming Ale and then Nale mentoring near Vuma. There's, I think, Osrumi. Am I right? Yeah. The services helping us. We appreciate that always. And we try our level best. I know sometimes, because you see, when you talk, yeah, send Katele Manji. Send Katele Manji. I mean, I'm trying to call a meeting in the whole day. I'm a politician, I'm a business people. So, we do try our level best. But sometimes I think it depends what it means when you say government is not there. Because you see, when you talk township economy, we don't mean every initiative must be supported by government in the townships. We don't mean that. Sometimes we might have, you see, we have helped Umam Sheila, but there's no board at her place that says government helped here and all that, because that's not the intention. There's a lot of people that we are helping and not. But like you're saying, maybe it's not enough, and I don't think it will ever be enough. Because the problems we face are huge. The money issue is not a joke, especially for business, black businesses. I know sometimes it's easy to say, save money, don't this, you say that. But if somebody in your, there's a small child who must go to a school trip, you can't say, no, I'm saving my business money. I can't pay for you. Unfortunately, our circumstances are different as blacks. And that is why it's important that as blacks, we must work together. Because even here, the reason why you must network. How, if you go to townships, for instance, and you want a builder or a painter or whatever, where do you go? There is no platform.
Who must create that platform? That's the point. And I always raise this issue. If when you are here, people are doing different things. By the time you leave here, will you have made contact with one person or one, or just going to eat and then you leave with your friend? You don't know. So that's what I'm talking about. Because we don't have a choice, guys. We must work together. So this thing of sitting in a corner and just pointing a finger and blaming, it's not going to help. We must work together. Because the difference between you and a young black businesswoman is that by the time they go into business, most of them, those who are coming from, they already have some few millions. And the father is the CEO of whatever company, and the friend to the father is the CFO of whatever company, and what so it's easy for them. But when you do that networking in government, they say it's corruption. That's what they say. The liberal white media, they say it's corruption. Because they don't want you to network amongst yourselves. Because once you network amongst yourself and you succeed, then it means power relations will change. Because you will be having money to be able to do all sorts of things and all that. So this issue of money, it's not a light issue. It must not be taken for granted. And it will never be resolved as long as we work in silos, Tina, and we don't support each other. If I supply stationery, I must not go and rent a car from, what is this? Avis or whatever, for example. You can use your neighbor's van. But you know what's the problem? Somebody will be saying, I don't know if you are lawyer, I'm not even 17. You see? So you don't want, isn't this in jail? Now you must go, you're nigga be lungi man, because you are lawyer, hey, young funny mean and all that. Those things won't help us. Let's change our mentality. As long as we don't change our mentality, we'll come here next year this time and we'll be accusing each other. No, you called us. And since that meeting, I've never been helped. My business is still stuck where it is and all that. We should be coming back again next year this time, and we should be hearing more positive stories saying, since that meeting, yes, I was helped. I now got the property. I was helped through working with somebody here or another person, sahlanganisimali, and bought something and all that. That's what we want. Not wait and say, yeah. And at that time, you would have forgotten. Now it's a... now it's 2016. So next year it will just be on the eve of election. But I speak about my elections. You would have forgotten that we had this meeting and we agreed that we must meet continuously. No, that's what happens. Yeah, but I speak about my elections. And there's no elections, nothing now. Because we are very much interested. We are very much interested in your success. Because if you succeed, and that's why we don't want chance takers who just want to get government money and leave. We want you to succeed, because if you succeed, we are succeeding. If you create jobs, it means we are creating jobs. So for us, it's not a PR exercise that we must just help some few people in jail. No, we must make sure that if we give you money, your business succeeds. Because if it succeeds, it means we are succeeding. So we are very, very, very interested in this partnership. So take it serious. And we are taking it serious as well. We will deal with those few rotten apples. But I can tell you, the most of our people who work there at Gauteng Enterprise Propeller, they are doing their level best. It's not everybody who's not there. There's just few people there. And we are attending to them systematically and properly. So that we take them out of the system. Those who are rotten potatoes, we don't want them in the system. Because they say once... spoils the whole bag. And that's why everybody comes here and say, GP, you don't work. And yet, they are trying their level best. But don't be scared to criticize. We are your government. You must criticize us. We can never be perfect. And that is why I'm saying, what is important is the mentality. Don't just criticize because of the
You speak, and that's what happens. I wonder, I'm telling you, my child, most cases they speak, I said to Mutua Ham. Hey, who belong to that? I'm Bachelil and I'm Sanje, Brahman. So don't tell us because of Funubus Palse. Tell us because whatever you raise is important to help us improve. If we're not delivering, tell us we are not delivering. But if you are delivering, you must also tell us. So I think the meeting went very well for a start. We must continuously have this dialogue. It can be on social media. We are on all platforms. We can have these discussions. And we can have one-on-ones sometimes. We will meet in the different areas that you operate in to also do visits and see some of the things that you are doing. Thank you very much.